Hey everybody, it's Damon here at Big AZ Speakers. Just doing a quick demo for this DBX120X. It's a subharmonic synthesizer. Basically goes through your equalizer tape loop, but also has a low level output for running a subwoofer as well. But before I list this for sale, I just wanted to tell you why I like it. I just did a video for my 3BX, which I didn't do any talking on, but if you go back to that one, this one I really like. Now, I don't use these in professional, like rack setups or anything like that, which is pretty popular with a lot of this DBX stuff, but just for my home audio use, I use this one. Has the, really does a good job at making like drums and snares and things like that. Really crisp and clean, makes your in your bass pop a little bit more. This particular 3BX with the restoration, impact restoration, these are pretty pricey. They don't last very long when I have them, but the DBX 120X, these aren't very, not that expensive, and I've had a lot of them and I never really put it to use until I was running my Heresies, and if you know anything about the Klipsch Heresies, really good sounding speakers, but like most people say, they lack really any bass. This 120X does a really good job at bringing some low end bass into your system without really screwing up the mids and highs. And surprisingly, I was worried about hooking it up, running it on the Heresies, the very sensitive speaker, but it actually did bring out a little bit of a bass for the Heresies. They kept their beauty. I didn't overdrive them. Obviously, if you put them all the way to their max, you'd have to be careful with overdriving the Heresies, but you can find a sweet spot on here that really add to what those make. Doesn't take away from the beauty of the sound those speakers have, but gives you a little bit more of that low end that a lot of people say they lack. So, they're good. They work. They do that for any speaker, but if you're a Heresy guy and you don't feel like screwing with the crossovers, this might be a good alternative. Or even if you have rebuilt the crossovers, something to take a look at. So, but obviously the videos just show you it works. You're not going to hear more bass or less bass through my microphone on my camera, but just want to show it's working, so I'll post it for sale here later tonight, and it'll be available directly at my website at www.bigazspeakers.com. That's big az like Arizona speakers.com. I do have it, we'll have it listed on my other sales channels as well, eBay and Reverb, but I don't charge tax if you go direct through my site, so there's the incentive. So let me dial up, season this is my DAC. So we're on the old Model I's. Does have a bypass button. Using the Carver setup here. Hit the bypass. So again, I doubt you'll be able to tell the difference, but I'll go ahead and turn the bypass off. Thank you. anyways, thanks for tuning in. So I just wanted to share what I liked about this unit and how it's helped improve my stereo system. But again, if you're looking to add some tighter bass, it is tight bass. I believe it cuts out like the sub harmonics, so you don't get the your speaker wobbling. So it does a good job of cutting that out. But most importantly, like I said, is it doesn't screw with the mids and highs. So you can find a sweet spot in here, get your bass just where you like it, and still enjoy everything else that you're already enjoying with your system. So all right, thanks again. Stay tuned, and have a wonderful night.